Hi there guys, Tom Quayle here, back for Guitar Interactive magazine with another review, and today we're checking out this fantastic amp here. This is the Dover DA20CE, or custom edition, as I say, from Dover Amplification. Now, Dover Amplification are a brand new brand from the UK, and they are doing everything design and building in England, which is fantastic. You can see here we've got this Union Jack flag going on here. So what we've got is superb quality components, fantastic build quality, and awesome tone in a boutique point-to-point format. So this is hand-wired in a very surprisingly affordable package. I mentioned in our previous Dover reviews where we checked out the DA20 and the DA50, that we've all kind of got used to the idea of spending huge amounts of money on boutique American-made amplifiers. But actually, doesn't need to be the case. This British amp here, which is a fantastic pedal platform and gain platform unto itself, is, you know, it's not cheap, but it's not crazy expensive either. So it's definitely affordable. Now the DA20CE, as I say, is a point-to-point hand-wired amplifier that is definitely aimed at professional guitar players and especially touring guitar players who like to use a pedal platform, pedal kind of board platform, as their main source of gain and effects. The reason for that is that this amplifier has a fully switchable voltage system on the back that allows you to alter the voltage for anywhere you are playing in the world. Now, unlike the DA20 and the DA50 that don't have those, you could literally take this anywhere, you know, any country you like, and make sure that this was actually giggable and wasn't going to blow up on stage, which is a really useful feature for touring musicians. So that's great. Now, the amp itself is very simple in its design. It's a single channel amplifier featuring a trio of ECC 83 or 12AX7 preamp valves or tubes for our American brothers and sisters. It also has a pair of EL84s in the power stage, giving it 20 watts of all tube power. It's a fantastic sounding, very dynamic, pick sensitive kind of amp. And surprisingly, unlike a lot of kind of clean pedal platform amps on the market, this actually has a decent amount of gain on tap as well. So you could just stick some delay and reverb in the effects loop, or just run it completely dry and just use the gain on board with the master cranked if you wanted to get some kind of higher gain, sort of, you know, into bluesy kind of light rock kind of territory if you wanted to. But the way I've got this set up is I've got my pedal board with the effects, like the delays, reverbs, modulations in the effects loop, and then all the drives in the front. And you can do that because it's got a fantastic sounding all tube effects loop on there, which is a super cool addition considering that there is gain on board. Now, in terms of the way the amp operates, we've got a master volume, three band EQ, bass, mid and treble. Then we have this gain control, but the gain control functions as a boost as well if we pull it out. So it's got this dual function where we've got a cleaner kind of gain when it's pushed in, and then we pull it out and we get this boost function, which adds in this kind of lovely natural tube overdrive. So we'll check that out first. I've got a Strymon Timeline and a Strymon Big Sky in the loop. And you heard in the intro, the boosted section with the gain riding just over halfway up, basically the settings you can see here with the master volume on half. Now this is a 20 watt amplifier, so it's nice and loud. You can definitely gig with this. And now underneath we've got our 1x12 here that Dover have supplied us with, and it's their 1x12 with a vintage 30 speaker, and it sounds great, but we cannot mic this up in this room. I'm at home at the moment in my home studio, and I can't stick mics in front of this and crank the amp up and give you a good representation of what's going on here, because there's no attenuation on this amplifier. So what I've done instead is I'm actually running this into a two notes Torpedo Captor X, which is running a 2x12 vintage 30 cab with a Royal 121 and SM57. And you're hearing no effects on there at all. All the delay and reverb is coming from the Strymon Timeline and Big Sky. And we will check out some of the tones on offer here. This is the closest I could get to this 1x12 cab using the Torpedo Captor X. So that's why we're doing it that way. And then we can crank the master volume. So let's start with the gain control backed off and the master volume relatively high. We'll set our EQ controls in the middle, and we get, it's a really touch sensitive amplifier. Sounds awesome. Now, the first thing we'll do is we'll check out the range of gain that's on tap here. So if I bring the master volume back, and crank the gain without the boosting gauge. There's a surprising amount of gain on board here, but huge amounts of control that we can have from the volume control of the guitar. So as you can hear, a huge amount of dynamic range from basically just the guitar. I didn't touch anything else, and that's with the gain maxed out. Now the beautiful thing here is, because this has the effects loop on, obviously you can use the gain on the amplifier and you're not compromised by the fact that you've just got the one input on the front. You've got the effects loop for your delays, reverbs or modulations, whatever you want to put in there, which is, again, a very nice feature that I'm glad they added onto this, you know, what was ostensibly a pedal platform style, you know, single channel amplifier, which is very cool. Now, if we engage the boost, you can hear there just from the noise level, because I've not got a noise gate going here, that we've got more gain. And now, and you can hear the natural tube compression that's going on there in the attack. So it's surprising how much you've got going on there in terms of the gain. Now, if we back this off with the boost on, let's just check out the EQ controls before we engage a drive pedal in the front of the amp. So we'll start with the treble. Give that a boost. And if we back that off, in true kind of point-to-point style, there's a kind of lovely, rich, creamy darkness to this amplifier. Beautiful. So we'll bring that back up again. Now we'll play with the mids. So back those off. Back up again, and then we'll play with the bass. Let's back that off. Then all the way up. So kind of subtle controls at this kind of gain level. Let's bring things back down to a kind of a cleaner territory. And increase the master volume. Back the bass off. Thank you. So it gets nice and clean if we want that. Now let's add a pedal in the front end. So we're going to use the one plugule fusion here. Let me turn that on. Okay, so now we've got the one plugule fusion in and we're running pretty clean on the front end. Let's increase the gain here. Engage the boost. So you can totally get lots of gain out of this if you push the front end with a pedal here. But it still retains that lovely pick dynamics and sensitivity that you want. It's a fantastic amplifier, a really great pedal platform for any touring musicians or actually anybody looking for a versatile pedal platform that's got more than just your standard kind of clean tones going on. You want to be able to use some kind of either preamp gain or push the master harder and get some kind of saturation from those power tubes as well. It's all possible with the DA20CE or the custom edition version of the DA20. Very, very cool indeed. And again, for a point-to-point, boutique, handmade, British-made or English-made amplifier. This is surprisingly affordable, so well worth checking out, guys. As usual, if you enjoyed the review, you can check out the full text in the magazine for our full thoughts and the rating that we gave this particular amplifier. I've loved playing through this. I think it's fantastic. And yeah, as I say, I hope you enjoyed the review. My name's Tom Quayle, and I will see you all in the next one. Bye-bye.